Once upon a time, voices of the o'o birds filled the forests of Hawaii. Their ancestors arrived between 14 and 17 million years ago. The o'o were the very first Hawaiian birds of the forest. There's a boy who lives in Honolulu named Manu O'o Mauloa, Hawaiian for May the o'o bird live on. Manu wonders, why was I named after a bird that's extinct? And if it's extinct, how can it still live on? Manu begins a quest to understand the meaning of his name and wants to learn everything he can about his namesake. He discovers that o'o birds were Hawaiian honey eaters found nowhere else in the world. They had tongues shaped like straws for sucking nectar from flowers. Males and females sang duets together. Manu learns about his Hawaiian heritage, the magnificent battle cloaks and helmets and featherwork from his culture, the respected feather hunters, their bird-catching tools and techniques. Manu experiences the relationship between animals and habitat. In Hawaii Volcanoes National Park, he sees Hawaiian birds for the very first time. He meets endangered birds being cared for by humans, including the alala, the Hawaiian crow, who will be released into restored habitat to start a wild population. On Mauna Kea, Manu helps regrow a native forest by planting baby koa trees. Secretly, Manu hopes he will find a living o'o bird and has vivid dreams about an o'o who becomes his friend. By the end of the story, Manu learns that extinction is forever, but there are things he can do to help wildlife. I developed the art in Manu, the Boy Who Loved Birds, from sketches that I transferred onto recycled rubber blocks. I carved and printed the blocks and then colored the prints with pencils. All art and text were researched extensively and reviewed for accuracy by biologists and Hawaiian cultural specialists. And afterward includes in-depth information on Hawaii's forest birds, featherwork, a glossary, and a list of things we can do to help. I created this book in partnership with University of Hawaii Press and Conservation Council for Hawaii, and is also available in a Hawaiian language edition, translated by Blaine Namahana Tolentino. This story is inspired by a real boy whose parents wanted to teach their son about the relationship between habitat and wildlife, and how restoring native places can help save our native birds.